In this video, I'm going to show you step by step how to connect to Pocket Network RPC servers instead of the default servers in MetaMask. Hello everyone, welcome to One Life Investments. If you're new here, welcome to the channel. Make sure you subscribe and hit the bell icon for regular, helpful, no hype crypto content and guides. And please like the video if you find it helpful. Pocket Network has RPC endpoints for different layer ones, for example, Harmony, ETH, BSC, and much more. The thing to keep in mind for now is that there are limitations on number of requests. Each RPC endpoint has limits on the number of requests that can handle and that can be easily found in the documents. All the descriptions, all the websites and the documents mentioned in this video will be in the description, so make sure you check that out if you find it difficult to find these documents. The information for all the network RPC servers and everything will be in the documents, and as always it will be in the description like I said earlier. Now, to change or to add a network, what you do is open MetaMask. As you can see on the top at the moment, I'm connected to Gorilla Test Network. You can click on Add Network and this will take you to the settings page. And all you gotta do is add the network name, URL, chain ID. Everything has to be very correct. Network name can be anything that you prefer, or you can just put a standard name. It's up to you, but you gotta make sure that the RPC URL and the chain ID is exactly correct and exactly the same that has been given to you. Now, what you do is go back to that documents, and depending on the network you want to add, for example, if you are playing DeFi Kingdoms on Harmony, then you want to go Harmony MetaMask, and then you're going to add this network, and then you can connect to the RPC endpoint on Harmony. But if you want to go and connect to RPC network on Ethereum, then you go to Ethereum MetaMask and then you add this. So different networks and different layer ones have their own RPC endpoints. That's all I'm trying to say. For example, this morning, 4th of Feb, depending on when you're watching this video, Venezuela and Iran were blocked from MetaMask or from Infura, which runs the RPC nodes. Infura, which runs the RPC nodes for Ethereum. And this is actually helpful for those users who have been affected in terms of getting their funds across or stuff like that. So what you do is, after you've chosen which endpoint you're going to connect to or you need to connect to, depending on your network or depending on the layer one you're trying to use, you go open that and copy and paste. Always copy and paste, never type it, because sometimes you might type something wrong, but when you look at it, it might look correct. Once that's done, you have that, you copy it, network name, it can be anything, or you can just write whatever's mentioned there. And this is the RPC URL, and put decimal one in the chain ID field, so that's one. The chain ID is currently used by the mainnet network. So at the moment, one is being used by that. So it's, and write ETH and block explorer. So what is, so if you put in a URL, so as you know that if you go to MetaMask and you click on these dots and you can go and view account on Etherscan and stuff like that. So if you don't have a block explorer URL mentioned here, then you won't be able to do that. That's the only difference. Click and save. And now I'm connected to Ethereum Pocket Network portal. It's exactly the same, but the only difference is my traffic is being routed via Pocket Network and not Infura, all right? Just make sure you give this video a thumbs up and make sure you check out other tutorials and guides and information on crypto. Thank you for being here and you have a nice day. Thank you.